says that yet. In the meantime, we do have some more news for you. Let's get to the rest of your headlines. We start with another Fox News alert because there's been a major earthquake that has shaken the Solomon Islands this morning. The 7.1 magnitude quake was centered about 130 miles from the country's capital. No tsunami warning has been issued and no word yet on any injuries or damage. The Solomon Islands is a country made up of nearly 1,000 islands on the Pacific Ocean. The U.S. consulate now in the thick of Mexico's drug violence. A small bomb was thrown at the U.S. consulate in Nuevo Laredo, Mexico, right across the border from Laredo, Texas. The bomb exploded on a patio and damaged some of the buildings. No one was hurt. So far, no arrests. The attack comes just weeks after the murders of three people connected with the U.S. consulate in Ciudad Juarez. Well, world leaders will be arriving in Washington today for the big nuclear summit this week. The first delegation to arrive will be the Nigerian delegation in about 90 minutes from now. The summit begins tomorrow. President Obama and other world leaders will discuss ways to reduce nuclear weapons, but the conference is not expected to produce any real results. One diplomat says the administration is sidestepping many touchy issues, including increasing inspections on nuclear facilities. Dixie Carter, who played the feisty Julia Sugarbaker on Designing Women, has died.
Just so you will know, and your children will someday know, is the night the lights went out in Georgia.
Carter's publicist said she died yesterday but would not disclose the cause of her death. The Tennessee native starred on Designing Women for 7 years and earned an Emmy nomination for her work on Desperate Housewives. Carter was 70 years old and is survived by her husband, actor Hal Holbrook, and their two children. Meanwhile, Shuttle Discovery astronauts are finishing up a spacewalk this morning. Astronauts Rick Mastracchio and Clayton Anderson are replacing
Rick and Clayton.
Yeah.
Wow. Nice. We've long said that you two should be in space. Are replacing an ammonia tank. The tank is a critical piece of the cooling system on the International Space Station. Meanwhile, NASA has extended Discovery's time at the space station by 1 day, and that's so Discovery's heat shield can be inspected for damage.
Those two, Rick and Clayton, did much better in school.
Apparently.
They're astronauts.
Imagine.
Right, you guys are just
asking. I'm slugging coffee.
Better at math. We just yap all day long.
Yeah.
I know. I'm not very well.